Well, you know, we actually had a couple duties while we were getting ready to let Starliner depart. There's some things that the International Space Station has to get ready and be prepared and make sure that it understands that a visiting vehicle has undocked and it goes back to its normal regime of operating. So actually, we were tasked with that. We were up in the cupola, and we were watching our spaceship, you know, fly away at that point in time. So I think it was good we had some extra activities. You know, of course, we're very knowledgeable about Starliner, so it was obvious, you know, what was happening at each moment. We were talking to our control team, people, friends of ours that we know how much time and effort that they have put into this spacecraft, the excellent and precision activities that they're doing down on the ground. It was nice to have that, you know, one-on-one conversation over the space to ground as Starliner was leaving, just knowing that she was in their hands and they were going to do the best that they could to get her back home. Other thoughts about seeing it leave, you know, like you mentioned we're both, you know, Navy, we've both been on deployments. We're not surprised when deployments get changed. I mean, our families, extended, our families are used to that as well. So that's not a humongous surprise. I think, like Butch said, this is test. I think before we even flew, we had an interview with a lot of you and mentioned the same thing, that, you know, a test flight means that we're probably going to find some stuff. We've done as much as we can to look at the envelope that we're going to operate in, but this is the first time that we've had humans in space in Starliner, and we did find stuff, and you know, we made the right decisions, and we're here, and that's how things go in this business. Like Butch said, it's risky, and that's how it goes in the business.
We'll go to Joey Roulette with Reuters.
Hey, thank you. For both of you, you know, you both have had, for the past few years, you've played a very kind of intimate role in Starliner's development, which, of course, has not been easy for Boeing for a number of reasons. And I know failures is common in spacecraft testing, but looking back, what could Boeing have done differently in Starliner's development?
That is a very interesting and a very fair question. I'll say this. There is not enough time right now to go into all the details to make any answer I think that I could give make complete sense. I could say a few things and it would be taken the wrong way, a way that I didn't mean it to be. So for questions like that, all that will play out in the coming months. We've got lessons learned that we will go through. We will have discussions. We will be involved with those discussions, and things that need to change will change. Obviously, when you have an issues like we've had, there's some changes that need to be made. Boeing's on board with that. We're all on board with that. And I can tell you, when you push the edge of the envelope again and you do things with spacecraft that have never been done before, just like Starliner, you're going to find some things. And in this case, we found some things that we just could not get comfortable with putting us back in the Starliner when we had other options. There's many cases in the past where there have not been other options. We were very fortunate that we have the space station and that we had the option to stay, and we had the option to come back a different way if that's what the data showed. I think the data could have gotten there. We could have gotten to the point, I believe, where we could have returned on Starliner, but we just simply ran out of time.